year is 1892. It's a Sunday, and four young men are walking on Mountain Drive, overlooking Grahamstown, Namakanda. There was a Wesleyan High School for girls, and they wondered about starting one for boys. They were all loyal members of the Commemoration Wesleyan Methodist Church. They believed that education severed from real faith was an incomplete ideal and an unsatisfactory achievement. To educate a child is also to form character, to discover what it means to be the full human beings God intended us to be.
Born out of the Methodist people, there was a strong link with the church, and Kingswoodians would walk down to worship at Kamem every Sunday. The boys were seated in the gallery, a gallery now famous for the wood carvings bearing the names of these schoolboys yearning for immortality. From 1894 until 1962, when the Kingswood Chapel was built, the gallery at Kamem was the school chapel. Kingswood still maintains links with Kamem, and we worship there once a term. Although the chapel was opened in 1962, the original suggestion that Kingswood should have a chapel of its own was first made on the 14th of March 1903 at the first AGM of the Old Kingswoodian Club. The idea lay dormant for some time and was raised again in 1946. Some felt that a science block should take preference, and so two funds were started. The chapel was officially opened on the 5th of August 1962. The Kingswood Memorial Chapel is built to honour the lives of Kingswoodians lost in various wars over the years. The design of the building was carefully thought out. The chapel is built in the shape of a cross, to remind us that salvation is through Jesus Christ and that He bore our sins on the cross. The chapel, like many churches, is also built on an east-west axis. There is therefore a north and south transept. The first Christians faced east when praying. The sun rises in the east, and so the first light creeps through the arrow port windows, symbolizing Jesus as the light of the world, light out of darkness, life out of death, hope out of despair. The tower stands four square, not only lifting our thoughts to God, but reminding us that God is everlasting, the Alpha and the Omega.
Stained glass windows were among the first ventures of humankind into the realm of audiovisual education. The windows on the northern or left-hand side of the chapel reflect incidents from the Old Testament and depict incidents that point to the coming of Christ. The windows on the south side or right side of the chapel depict New Testament events.
The west window, which is the memorial window, portrays a sailor, soldier, and an airman kneeling towards angels holding out to them the crown of life. It is a reminder of the destruction to which sin and the selfish greed of men and women can lead. It is a constant reminder of the precious lives of old Kingswoodians lost through the violence of war.
It is often said that the chapel is the heart of Kingswood.
The entire college can fit into the chapel, and it is used for a variety of events. Assemblies, music concerts, prize givings, knighting ceremonies, grandparent days, plays, inductions, and Neil Agat lectures are just some of what happens in this space. It is here that many Kingswoodians hear the Word of God preached in powerful and sometimes unusual ways. Here we pray. We break bread together. Some confirm their faith and are baptized. A team of junior and senior chapel stewards work with Rev to facilitate worship services and care for our community. We trust that lives would be changed by the love of God, and our pupils will become transforming influences on society.
If you came onto Kingswood's campus and you wanted to find your direction on the compass, you could use the sun, you could use a compass, your phone, or you could come into the chapel. And you'd know that as you walk in,
looking up towards the cross would be east, with the north and south transepts west at the back. By being in this place, you can find your direction, you can orientate yourself. In the same way, when we are in God's love, or to use St. Paul's phrase, in Christ, then we find our direction, we find our bearings. You see, following Jesus is not just about going to heaven or hell when you die. It's so much more than that. Jesus came to speak to us about a new way of living, about this God that desires intimacy with us. He called it the kingdom of God, this new way of living, of being together, and he invites us to participate in building that kingdom until eventually that is realized when he comes again. And so we have purpose and hope. Just like coming into the chapel, you know that you're facing east. That doesn't necessarily mean anything. But when we are in Christ, we know that God has got us, that there is purpose, that there is meaning. We don't see the full picture, but we have faith and we can have hope. You see, it's stormy out there. We need our direction. We need to find our bearings. And the storms are many. Racism, homophobia, gender-based violence, xenophobia, the list is long. And then, of course, there's the pandemic. 2020 has not turned out how any of us imagined. Even within our own community, there are people who have lost loved ones to COVID-19. There's loss of income. There's huge stress, anxiety, and uncertainty. Amatrix, in particular, this year hasn't turned out how they had imagined. You may also find that because of this crisis that we find ourselves in, all other unresolved issues in your life come to the fore. And so you find yourself not just dealing with the things that you're reading about in your news feed, but your relationships are strained, and even deep within yourself, things just don't seem right. But as a faith community, we are able to join hands with each other, even if it's virtually, to know that when I don't have enough faith, you can believe for me. And when you don't have enough faith, I can believe for you. And together, we will persevere, even thrive. The psalmist writes in Psalm 27, verse 14, "Wait for the Lord, be strong and take heart, and wait for the Lord."